Hi guys, and welcome back to another Minecraft tutorial. So today we're going to be learning how to build a small container ship in terms of subclass, and if you do want to actually check that out, you can always have a look on Google for container ship and see what the classes are. This one will actually be classed as a feeder ship, which is a very small one, or on a smaller scale of container ships. So this one is 137 blocks long, it's 29 wide and 42 blocks high. So it's still quite big, but in the kind of general scheme of container ships, it is a small one to get us started. This ship has been based roughly off the Husky Runner, so if you guys want to check that one out as well, feel free to do so. But I have added a lot of my own stuff into it. I've just used the Husky Runner as a kind of base and then just, you know, gone with my own ideas. It's quite difficult to actually find the specs on these type of ships, but that's the one it's based off. But it is kind of my own design, and I've called this one the Hermes. So I'm naming all of my container ships after Greek gods, and since this one's quite small, quite quick, I'm going to be calling it the Hermes. So the texture pack I'm going to be using for this tutorial is LD Modern, and as always there's going to be a link in the description. This tutorial is also 100% console friendly, so there's not going to be any kind of blocks that you guys don't have. If there is, just find the nearest fit. So there might be, for example, I use different coloured cobblestone walls. You guys have only got one, just use one. Simple as that. If you do end up using this build on a map or a server, please do give me credit for my design. It takes me absolutely ages to start building these, and also to even get through and do the tutorials, that takes even longer. So all I mean by this is just throw up a sign, probably in the bridge, just saying designed by Lord Dacca or built from Lord Dacca's tutorial, something like that, and then shove another sign right next to it saying built by and put your name. This really helps my name get out there, especially if you build this on a server. If my name gets out there and then I get bigger, that means that there's going to be more of these type of tutorials, which helps you guys out. Anyway, let's get stuck into this tutorial and let's get started. Okay, so where are we going to be building this one? Underneath the water. Now, you'll notice that I don't build mine underneath the water. The reason being, it's a lot easier for you guys to see, especially if I want to do, for example, freezes and say, that's what it looks like, or, you know, doing this. Whereas underwater, you guys can't see. It makes it a nightmare. That's the reason why I don't do it. But you guys that are building it, for example, on the console versions, where are you going to be building underneath the water? So this is where your water level is going to be. So say that the light blue is going to be water. If I did put water, it'd just spill everywhere. It's annoying. But anyway, so it's just going to be, if you had your blocks, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 5 blocks down, that's where your first layer is. So this block here will just be kind of surrounded by water. But you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So make sure that you just go down there, just place down a block, and that'll be our nice starting point. So quickly, I'm just going to explain of how I do my tutorials. We do need a red colour, so just go for a red or something. But the way I do mine is I want to be teaching you guys how to do it on one side, and then you'll be doing it on the other one. You'll pause the video and do the other. So here's an example. If I then said 2, 3, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then 1, then 1, I'd then say, then do this on the other side. What you guys would do is pause the video and then complete it on the other side. You'd probably just sit here and go, okay, so we did 3, 1, 2, 3. They go, ah, I don't know what they did there, or you can't see it clearly and you don't want to count. Just watch back the video. Since you paused it, you know, it's not too bad to rewind it. So you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. And then anything else I also tell you, just to, you know, like for example, fill in the floor. You then fill in the floor off camera, still paused. And there we go. If we just do this one, for example, like this. And then we'll get onto the next layer and we'd start again. And just I would show you how to do it on one, the other side, basically just one side. The reason I do this is it makes it a lot easier and actually makes the video length smaller. Now, usually these videos are really long because this is a big ship and most of my stuff is pretty big. So, let's get started anyway on layer number one. Okay, so for layer number one, what we're going to do is just obviously go down to that level that you had. Hopefully you guys placed a block. If not, watch that section again. But we're going to go here and we're going to go 3 blocks. 1, 2, 3. Next, we're going to go 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. We're going to have another 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Next one we're going to have is 5 sets of 3. So we got 1, 2, 3. That'll be your first one. Now, one thing you can do when you're counting multiple sets is put one right in the middle. So you go 1, 2, 3. That's 2. 1, 2, 3. 3. 1, 2, 3. 4. 1, 2, 3. 5. And what this allows you to do is when you look sideways, you can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Excellent. That's correct. This is what I use when I'm actually checking mine as well. So that's 5 of those. Then we're going to have a 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Next one, we're going to have a 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. After this, we're going to have 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then we're going to have a 28. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. So there we go. And if you guys were wondering, I'm just using Red Wool for this. You can use whatever you want. Just think of it as colours. And that's pretty much it. As soon as you think of things as colours, you just go, well, it's red, so use red. Anyway, we're now going to move in. We're going to have 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then we're going to have 2 sets of 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we're going to have a 3. 1, 2, 3. Another 3. 1, 2, 3. Then we're going to have a 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Another 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we're going to have a 3. 1, 2, 3. 2 sets of 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And was that just one? Yeah, there we go. Trying to read as well. 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 2 sets of 4 right there. Then you're just going to have a 2. So, you'll have, obviously, you guys will be doing the same on the other side going around, but we're also going to have on the back here, if we just count out a 10 block gap, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, they're going to have 3 blocks, 1, 2, 3. So, you can see I've used the wall there to show you guys, but you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 block gap, then 3 blocks. This is actually the back rudder that we got here. The actual main shaft bit we'll just do in one go, it's a little bit easier. What you guys are going to be doing is just do the same on the other side. Just copy it until it reaches this point. If you get stuck, always watch that first layer again. And of course, in the top left-hand corner, there is going to be the layer number. If I get onto the bridgey stuff, I might just say, you know, bridge layer 1, bridge layer 2, or whatever. It might change in that respect, but most of it will be layers going up. After you've actually done that on the other side, all you need to do is just fill in this, because this is the base of the ship. So you guys will just literally just be filling up the entire thing. So after you've done that, we'll get you and catch you guys for layer number 2. Okay, and now for layer number 2. So hopefully you guys have filled all that in as well. If not, you're going to have to. So pause the video and do it. Anyway, come to the front and go forwards by 3 blocks. So we're just going to go forwards off that. And we're just going to show one of these. And we're going to have a 5. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So there you go. That's what I mean by showing one of them. We'll go 5 there. Like that. So it's going forwards by that many, but yeah. If that makes sense. You're then going to have a 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Two sets of 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Don't worry about these missing bits. We're going to fill those in just a second. It's got 3, 3. Then we're going to have a 2. 1, 2. Like that. We're going to have 4 sets of 3 this time. So you've got 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So you've got... Oh, there we go. 4 sets of 3. 1, 2, 3. 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. 4 sets of 3. Then we're going to have a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then a 9, 1, oh god, I need to make sure that's a 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there we go. So you can always check if you get stuck, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And then I'm going to go out and have a 36. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36. So I'm going to double check this by using World Edit, which is always in, you know, kind of useful. There we go, 36 blocks, so just like that. Fly down, so that'll just be one less than, well, this layer that when it goes back in again. It's one less than that one. We're then going to have, well, start going inwards, so we're going to have 8, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Then we're going to have a 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then we're going to have a 3, 1, 2, 3. Then a 2. And then we're going to have a 3. And that's just going to be 3, 2, 3, 2, 3. So 3, 2, 3, 2, 3. 3, 2, 3, 2, 3. Just on that part. So we've actually, when we start doing the freeze, we go 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3. 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3. There you go. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we've got like 3 sets of 3 2s, and then just ends in a 3. Hopefully that's not too difficult. But now you're going to have a 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then you have a 1. Right there. And you'll notice this goes quite out, quite back, and that's actually how the ships do it. And then for the rudder, an extra 3 blocks. So when you've got the other side done as well, I kind of recommend doing it at the end. You'll notice you've got like gaps like this. You're just going to do it on the same layer that we've got, and if I miss out any of these ones when doing it in later layers, just fill it up like I'm doing right now. So notice that in some parts you've got loads to fill up, but it's always on the layer that we've just done that you'll be kind of adding the blocks to. If I don't say, sometimes I do it the other way, but not with a ship, so don't worry about it. And I always make it quite verbal what I do. So yep, fill up all of these parts. It's quite a lot, as you can see. But then after you've done that, do the same on the other side, and we'll get onto the next layer. Okay, and now for layer number three, come to the front, and what you're going to do is you're going to place a block. Actually, we're going to go forward, sorry. You're going to go forwards by two. It's forwards by two off those ones. And then we're only going to show one of them, so place a block right next to it. This is actually going to be a four. So you've got one, two, three, four. So counting that one that we added onto the side, just showing that one, two, three, four. Next, we're going to have a five. One, two, three, four, and five. Then we're going to have two sets of three. One, two, three, one, two, and three. Then we're going to have a two, three, two. So two, three. And then a two. Just like that. Two, three, two. Then we're going to have two sets of three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Then a four. One, two, three, and four. And then a seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. Like that. Now we're going to have 52. So it's starting to get a bit bigger. With cargo ships, they really do get wide quite a lot, actually. So 52, sorry. 52. I don't know if I said something else then. But all I'm going to do is I'm going to use my world edit to actually make sure I get this correct. So if I bring this all the way to this point here, have a look, we've got 42. So if we continue it on a little bit more, I'm going to have. So we go past this one, 50. And they go 1, 2. So it's just 2 past that last one we had. If I just deselect, there we go. So we go across here, it's just going to be 2 past this one right there, like that. Then what we're going to do is we're going to go start moving inwards. We're going to have 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Then we're going to have two sets of 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Now what we're going to do is we're going to do 2, 1, 2, 1. So 2, 1, 2, 1. Like that. Two sets of 2. So 2, 2. Like that. We're going to have a set of 3. 1, 2, 3. Not just one set of 3. I don't know why I said set of 3 on that one. Then we're going to have a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now what we're going to do is we're going to put in the propeller. So if you grab a block of iron and a block of gold, if you can, actually you can just put it in here to be honest, right, going into here. If you wanted to bring this all the way into the ship and make some sort of engine type thing, you can do. But from this point, we're just going to add 3 blocks. 1, 2, 3. Then put 2 blocks of gold. Then we're just going to make these go out at diagonal angles. So there we go, like this. Just like that. And the same on this side. So there you go, you can make something like that. The other things you can do is just make a triple one if you want to. Make it a little bit different, do something like this. That might also look pretty cool. So I'm going to do that one for this one. I've got the X on that one, so X or a Y. You know, you could try a Z if you want to, I don't know. But anyway, all you need to do now is just add an extra 3 blocks on this one. Do the same on the other side. And of course, as always, we're going to have loads of these to fill up. So you guys can fill those up as well. Do all of that, and we'll get on to the next one. Okay, and now for layer number four. So if you come to the front, we're just gonna go forwards by 1 block like this. We're then gonna have a five. One, two, three, four, and five. Now we're gonna have a four. One, two, three, and four. Then a three. One, two, three. Then a two, three, two, three, two. So we're gonna go two, three, two, three, two. Two, three, two, three, two. Right, so there you go. Two, three, two, three, and then two, just like that. Then we're gonna have a three, one, two, and three, and then a four, one, two, three, and four, and a five, one, two, three, four, and five. Now we're gonna have 62, so pretty long. What we're gonna do is just see where it just lands. I know that's straight on top of this one. As you can see, they really do have quite a wide middle section with these type of ships, especially the bigger ones. The bigger they get, the wider this bit actually gets stretched out to. There we go. If we bring it just directly on top, that gives us 56. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. So it's actually directly in line with that one. So there you go, it's directly in line with that one, across by one like that. So just get it onto that point. So then what we're going to do is we're going to have 6 blocks. So we're going to start moving inwards as well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Then we're going to have a 3, 1, 2, and 3. Then another 3, 1, 2, 3. Then we're going to have 6 ones. So you're going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Then we're going to have three sets of two. One, two, three, like that. Then on the rudder, just build up an extra one. And then obviously do the same on the other side, cover up all these little bits. You'll notice that the back does start to get very, very wide. These ships especially do this. They actually get really massively wide across here, and then start to actually bend up eventually, as you can see over here. Anyway, do the same on the other side, we'll get on to the next one. Okay, and now for layer number 5. So come to the front, and you're going to place one directly on top of the last one here. I'm going to move inwards just by one. So this is actually part of the bulbous bow, which starts to bend back, so actually on that part. Anyway, now what we're going to do is we're going to place down 5 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you notice it goes in slightly again, part of that bow. Then we're going to have 3 blocks. 1, 2, 3. 3 sets of 2. So you've got 1, 2, 3. So 3 sets of 2 right there. We're then going to have a 3. 1, 2, 3. 2 sets of 2. 1, 2, 1, 2. Like that. Then a 3. 1, 2, 3. Then a 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then we're going to have a 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then we're going to have 69 in total here. So, again, I'm just going to see where it lands by using World Edit to save us. It also makes it easier for you if I can just tell you how many blocks past the last one it is, if any. So if we just bring it right in line with this, we get 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69. So it's one short of that layer right there. I'll just deselect that. Now what we're going to do is we're going to start moving inwards, and we're going to have 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then 3, 1, oh, there we go, let's just check, I've got a 7 here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, there you go, and then here we're going to have 3 blocks, like that, we're then going to have a 2, and then a 1, then we're going to have 2 going the other way, so we're going to cross the ship, so 2 here like that, so there we go, you've got 2, 1, and 2 going this way, then we're going to have 6 sets of 1, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So it should just be one over that last bit there. As you can see, again, it's starting to get quite wide around here. Then just going to build this up by 3 blocks, as before. Do the same on the other side. Fill up all of these parts. And you can see we're getting quite... it does get quite wide in a way from this point here. So, you know, just fill up all of these. Do on the other side. And we're actually onto the black layer, I believe. Okay, so we're now on to layer number 6, which is the black layer. Now, because of video editing and YouTube rendering and all this kind of rubbish, what happens with black is you can hardly tell, you know, the shape-wise. So if I put a block right... Oh, actually, wait. I can't even find out where it is. There we go. Look, I put a block, didn't even notice it's there, but there we go, there's a couple blocks. Even I can't see it, so you guys definitely can't after editing. So what I'm going to be doing is I'll be using a different block. I'm going to use, like, grey wool for this. But you guys will be using black or block of coal, some sort of black type colour. Anyway, so grab that and just make sure that you think that this is black instead of light grey. Yeah, I know. But anyway, leave two of these ones. We're going to go move inwards. We're going to have 3 blocks. So you got 1, 2, 3. So there you go. You got these two here. This is part of the bulbous bow. Then we're going to have a total of 7 sets of 2. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So 7 sets of 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Just like that. We're then going to have a 3. 1, 2, 3. Then a 2. 1, 2. Then a 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you're going to have a 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then 76. So this is really long now. So if you just, we just do this. Let's do it the easy way. Just use that as a marker. Grab this all the way across here. All the way back. And let's see how far it is. Or how much more extended it is than the last one. I think it's quite a bit. This one. So if we bring it directly on top, see where it is there. So that is a total of 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76. So 76 in total. So if you guys do the same, point to there. Then what we're going to do is we're going to start moving inwards again. We're going to have 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Then we're going to have a 2, another 2. We're going to have 2 going across the ship, so 1, 2, like this. And then we're going to have 7 sets of 1. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. There you go, 7 sets of those. And then right on this back rudder, we're only going to have these two, which are going to be the black. So do the same on the other side, and then obviously you're going to be filling out this. So, you know, fill out all of these with your black wool, and we'll get onto the main colour. Okay, so we're now on to layer number 7, which is your colour So choose whatever, you know, choose a colored wool. Depending on what texture pack you got, you could also choose, you know, one on the stained clay. Whatever you're going to go with, this one's orange, you could use kind of common colors that are actually used on these are blue, green, and like red. But because we've got the red on the bottom, you'd probably need to then switch this out for black to make the red look right. But yeah, they're pretty common colors, just like blues and I think cyan you usually see on the really big ones, and the big mask ones you do see with those massive blues. So choose some sort of color. I'm going to do something completely different. I'm going to make a purple one because it's cool-ish. It's cool. Anyway, grab whatever color, doesn't matter what it is, your choice. And what you're going to do is you're just going to go to the front, go back by one block, so it's on top of your black. You just go one block there, and that's all you're going to have, just a one. You're then going to have a two, and then a two. And then what you're going to do is you're going to have a one. And then you're going to have four sets of two, so you got one, one, two, three, and four. So four sets of two like that. Three sets of three. One, two, three, one, oh, one, two, three, one, two, and then three. So three sets of three like that. Then you're going to have a five. One, two, three, four, and five. Now the next one's going to be 84 blocks. So again, I'm going to use this. I wonder what this purple ship's going to look like. It's going to look a bit odd, but well. It's more like lilac, isn't it, rather than purple with my texture pack. But let's bring this all the way on top. And there, and continue this on till we're directly on top. So there, that's 78, 980. Then just add 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. That should give us 84. So it's just going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 blocks over from the last layer that we had before. So we go if we deselect that. Now what we're going to do is we're going to start moving inwards. We're going to have 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then we have two sets of 2. 1, 2, 1, 2. Then 2 going the other way. 1, 2. Then what we're going to do is we are going to have, I think, 7 ones. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it should be 1 over this point here. So yeah, do the same on the other side. And again, filling up with these like this for your colour. You can see how wide it actually starts to get at the back and how it's actually supported going like this way. Quite big circles. But yeah, do the same on the other side and we'll get on to the next one. Okay, now for layer number 8. So this one's going to be, well, it's going to start directly on top. So you're just going to place down a 1. I'm going to go 1, 1, 1. So 1, 1, 1 of that kind of front block. So you get 4 of those in total. We're then going to have 4 sets of 2. So you got 1, 2, 3, and 4, like that. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we're going to have 3 sets of 3. 1, 2, 3, 1. 2, 3, 1, 2, and 3, like that. Then a 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Then a 90. So there we go, we've got 90. So I'm going to see where this one lands. I think it goes over a little bit, anyway. Because we had last time, we had 84, so it's a bit longer. Yeah, let's keep on going. Da-da-da-da-da, really long run. But there we go. So if we're direct on top, that's 85. So just add 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I'll bring you in line with that one. Brill. So there we go, got that. Next, we're going to move inwards and we're going to have 5. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then we're going to have a 1, 1, like that. And 2. Then we have 2 going the other way, like this. Going to cross. And then we're going to have 5 1s. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then 3 going across the back, like this. So you've got 3 across the back. So again, do the same on the other side. Cover up this back piece. It's starting to. Well, eventually it'll round anyway. The back of these kind of type of ships is really weird. So yeah, just fill this up, do the same on the other side, and we'll get on to the next one. Okay, and now for layer number 9. So come to the front. It's going to place a block directly on top, and then you're going to add one to each side. So it's starting to get quite flat. Usually these are quite flat at the front, especially as it goes up. Yeah, let's keep on moving backwards. So we're going to have three sets of one. So you've got one, one, and then one. We're then going to have a 2, 1, 2, then a 1. Then we're going to have a 3. So you've got 3, 1, 2, 3. Then a 2, 1, 2, another 3, 1, 2, and 3. Then what we're going to do is we're going to have a 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then what we're going to do is we're going to have 99. Oh, yeah. Really bloody long. So anyway, let's just drag this one all the way back. It's going to take a while. We'll see where we are And I think it's just going to be plus 8 blocks, I think. I think we're just one on the other side. Yep, keep on getting this one back. God, it takes so long, doesn't it? There we go. So 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99. So, oh, God. Where? So that's just one. Also, six blocks over. I don't know how I counted that. Yeah, six blocks over the last one, which will give me 99 blocks. So then we're going to move inwards again. Going to have three blocks going across here. Then a one. Then a two. Then we're going to have two going the other way. So two going across. And then a one. And I'm going to bet 11 going across the back. So you got one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. So there we go. It's starting to hit the back now. So again, fill up this point. You're getting used to it. I think it's one at the front as well. Random one. Yeah, fill up this. Do it on the other side. And we'll get on to the next one. Okay, and now for layer number 10. Come to the front. We're going to go forwards off this one. And it's going to be three across again. So just going forwards off that block right there. We're then going to have two going across this way. So it's quite wide, this. We're trying to make this quite wide, I guess. We're gonna have a one, and then a two going the normal way, which is cross ship this way. We might as well cover up these two as well while we're there. So just squiggles around like that, and then we're gonna have a one, a two, another two, like this. Then we're gonna have a three, one, two, and three, a four, one, two, three, four. There we go, one, two, three, four. Then we're gonna have a six, one, two, three, four, five, and six. Then we're gonna have 106. 106, yeah. Pretty long. Let's just do it the easy way. Use world edit. See how many it is over. So if you drag this one back, there we go. Keep on going. Good God, it's starting to get really long now. Yep, drag it back. What's that? I think I might need a. Oh, there's a couple more blocks I need to fill in at the front, that's why. Anyway, just saw that like twinkling in there. Anyway, bring it right to there. That gives us 101. So we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's our 106. So, excellent. Just deselect that now. Then, what we're going to do is we're going to go in and do 3, 1, 2, 3. Now, this one goes across the side but connected on. So just connect on 2. So you go 1, 2. So it's showing 3 on this side, showing 3 on that side as well. So, pretty simple. And then there's just 17 across the back. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Six, what's that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So there you go. Do the same on the other side, and we'll get on to the next one. Okay, so now we're on to layer number 11. So come to the front, and we're going to go forwards again with these three blocks going across. So we're starting to go more up, I guess. Kind of moved in from here, and then coming back up again. We're also going to go two across with the other way. So two across, like this way. I don't know what's easier to show you guys, but then I'm gonna have a one and a one, so one and a one. Then we're gonna have a two, one, two, then a one, then a three, one, two, and three. Then we're gonna have a two, one, two. Then we're gonna have a four, one, two, three, and four. Then a six, one, two, three, four, five, and six. And then the next one is gonna be 111. 111 blocks. So let's do it the easy way again, because who wants to count 111 blocks? Not me. Definitely not me. So let's drag all this all the way back, all the way back, all the way, all the way, all the way. Oh God, this is the only thing about these long ships and cargo ones are really like this. They're really flat. So let's get it directly on top of that one. So that's 108, 9, 10, 11. So add three blocks to it, and we'll get this. Brill. So it'll be directly in line with that bit that goes across. We're now going to add an extra block here. So it just gets two going this way, and then this is going to be 21 blocks going across. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. And that's it. So do the same on the other side, and I don't think there's any extra blocks we need to cover up. But where we're actually at is where I've got this, where I've got Hermes written on the side, and I will show you where I've actually written it. It doesn't matter at all, but I'll show you where it's anyway. This is actually where we are, the deck here. So we've got this tiny little deck, but we've got this raised bit. So we're actually going to put in these side bits later on, after we've got probably at least the next layer. I mean, we'll see how it goes. We'll see how I'm going to play this, but we'll probably have to finish off the front part first. The back's probably going to be the longest part, because it's a little bit more complicated, but we'll do that in a whole chunk. We'll try and get the rest of the ship done first. Okay, and now the way I've decided to split this up is we're going to finish off the front because we can do this part layer by layer. It's kind of a bit raised. So it kind of makes sense to just do it, layer by layer, continue it on, do all that. We're then going to do the top box part here, this back boxy part, do the anchory bits, and then we're going to do the back section as a whole piece. So we're going to get most of this done, pretty much all of this in. Well, it shouldn't take too long, especially these parts. These are really easy. So anyway, let's get to the front, and we're going to be doing this layer by layer. So this is going to be layer number 12 for the front. So three blocks on top, and add one to each side. So I'm just going to add one to each side like this, like that. So we've got five going across. We're going to have two going across the side of the ship, so two going across this way. And then what we're going to do is going to have a one and a one. Then we're going to have a two, another two, one, two. Then we're going to have a three, one, two, and three. Then we're going to have a four, one, two, three, four. A six, one, two, three, four, five, and six. And then we're going to have a 17, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17. Just land there. So this front shouldn't take too long, so then just do the same on the other side and we'll get on to the next bit. Okay, and now for layer number 13 on the front, what we're going to do is we're going to move forwards, and we're going to have five going across. So it's going to be forwards of this one, like that. And then we're going to do is going to have two going across. So two going across this part again to keep on with this very flat kind of face, I guess. We're then going to have a one and another one. Then we're going to have a two, one, two. Then a one. Then a three, one, two, three, and then a four, one, two, three, four. Then we're gonna have a six, one, two, three, four, five, and six. Then we're gonna have an 18, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Should give you one short. So again, do the same on the other side, and we'll keep on moving up. Okay, and now for layer number 14 at the front, what we're gonna do. We are going to be forwards of this one by three blocks, so we're just going to have three blocks like this. Sorry, three blocks going across, not forwards, just in case you got stuck. Yeah, just three blocks forwards of this, just like that. There, then we're going to have three blocks going across this time, one, two, and three. So it's kind of connected in, as you can see, trying to make this kind of smooth-ish shape. We're then going to have a one and a one, so one and another one like that. Then a two, one, two, then a one, then a two. And then we're going to have a 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then a 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and then a 19, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, which will be, again, one short. Do the same on the other side, and we'll work our way up. Okay, and now for layer number 15 for the front section. Going to move forwards and just have 1, so that's it, we're just going to move forwards by 1. Then we're going to have 3 going across, like 1, 2, 3, like this. Just going to cross the side. Then we're going to have two going across. So we've got one, three, and then two. Then it's back to the normal way that we do things. So we're going to go one, 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 one. Just like that. Then a two, one, two. Then a three. So one, two, and three. And then we're going to have a six. One, two, three, four, five, and six. Then a 21. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. And 21, which will land again in like a step pattern going up. And all you need to do with this one is just fill up that one right there, like that. So do the same on the other side, and we'll get on to the next bit. Okay, and now for layer number 16 for the front section. There's going to be seven across the front, so we're just going to place a block on top of this one, add three blocks to each side, one, two, three, one, two, three, like that. So that's where our starting point is. Then just going to have two going across here. So we've got two going across this point right here. Then we're going to have four sets of one. So you've got one, two, three, and then four. So four sets of one going across. Then a three, one, two, and three. Then we're going to have a four, one, two, three, and four. And a nine. A nine. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and nine. Then what we're going to do is we're going to have seven blocks of iron bars. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then we're going to have a purple wool. Then another 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then another one like that. Now, in my texture pack, if you do have Optifine, and if you also have Word Edit, you can actually do REPL 101 colon 5, which is the one I recommend for ships. Just give you this one. That's the one I'm going to be using. So then you can replace these blocks for those. But yeah, do the same on the other side. And then what we're going to do is we'll probably start putting in all of this big section. I think if we start with this front part right here, I'm putting the stairs and things, then we can start putting in the big blocks and then finish off the front. Okay, and now for the kind of front, well, this part in a way. Yeah, this part. Anyway, what we're going to do first is, now, this is where the actual level is. I'm going to be using cobblestone for this because my cobblestone, my texture pack is grey. You can also use grey wool, so most people will be using grey wool for this. Just put down a couple of blocks, don't go all the way because it doesn't go all the way. But then with your stone stairs, you can put this up, and that's why I've used cobble because then it fits in. Oh, if I can actually jump up. I'm going to put these up like this, right to this point here, and then this is where we're going to have all this section in. So we're just going to put in a little bit of flooring here, and this will go all the way to the side, to right up to here. Just put it up to there for now, just doing a single block. And if we go right next to the stair here, when we put that first stair, we're just going to grab our light grey wool and we're going to go up by 7. So you're going to put one right next to it and go 1, and that's counting that one as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now this is going to go this way towards the front of the ship. It's going to be 25 in total. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. And that will go obviously down to like here. I'm just going to use World Edit to speed up this, but you guys would obviously fill this in. So there we go. Have it there, and of course over here we're going to have to fill it in where we got the stairs, like that. We're going to cross. Then this will just go straight across. So I'm also going to just do this with World Edit, and that will be where you get the normal floor. So just fill this in there, and where are the stairs? Stairs are going to be here. Oh, not there. There, there. And then keep on going down to this point where it's just flat. So there. So if we just bring this across to wherever it is over here. There, so that's the block. So if I just bring that to there. There we go. I'm just going to set that one with World Edit. And do the same as well. Oh, yeah. Let's bring this over here to this bit. And I just might as well put the rest in by hand. So we have this going across and join this. So it's right next to that stair where it goes, and then just cover up these bits. And then these two will join just directly across. So here to here is also going to be solid. So there we go. The joys of World Edit make it a lot easier. And then we get this big kind of square platform. Now with this, we're actually going to fill it up with just cobblestone, so or cobblestone, grey wool, that kind of stuff. Put that in here. So we go. This here, I'm just going to fill in again with World Edit. You guys will take a little bit longer to fill it in if you're on the console versions. But there you go, you have that. Now, if you grab your light grey wool again, we're going to go down the center of this. So if we find the center, go from here, and this is where we're going to fill in. Just from this point, I'm going to go straight across. This is supposed to be a line between the two, either panels of the thing, or if you're using hydraulics, we actually where they're connected in, because with these kind of doors, these will obviously actually go down. You've got to store containers underneath this inside the ship. That's why it's so big. Now you could, if you wanted to, do stuff like this to make it look like it's actually connected in. So I'm going to do that on just this side, maybe. I'll do it on the other side as well. There you go. You see it should figure itself out. I think I got it right on the other one as well. If not, it doesn't really matter too much, but there we go. So if we put in these are like the hatches. If you wanted it open as well, I'll show you a small example of that if you wanted to. I'm not going to show you the whole thing open. But if you did, for example, if we had the same kind of setup, we had a small kind of box, and we had these, all you have to do is put this to there, and then build the same height up, with these bits, to make like a door. So it just looked like that, but going up. Just do that. It's really easy. Really is easy way of doing it. So if you wanted to have those open, you could do. But now what we're going to do is we are going to fill up this front deck. So if we just fill up this right to here, and this is going to be all fours of this. And you can see it's one block down. That should allow you to walk around at least. And yeah, what I'll do is actually, if you guys just fill this up, I'll catch you and tell you what to do next. Okay, and now what we're going to do is this is kind of like front guard piece. They're usually a lot bigger, it's just that they don't look that good usually. I do have a couple of them on my other ones which are massive, but anyway. I'm just going to go onto this side piece here. We've got the bit with the rail. Just follow that to the front, then we're going to go 1, 2. Then we're going to have a slab. Then we're just going to bring this block all the way across. So bring this block all the way across. Across, then we go 2 blocks and the slab. Then we're going to leave 5 of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Go to the 6th, and that's where we're going to put slabs on top. Like that. And there as well. And I leave 5 on the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I need to cut off a couple. And if we go down here, it's going to leave a 2-block gap so you can actually walk in. And then this will be solid. So do the same on the other side. 1, 2, put one down there. And of course, I'm going to use Wild Edit to save myself some time. I can find the command. There we go. Like that. So that'll give you your front guard. Now what we're going to do is we're just going to do a couple of these little connecting pieces. These are just to stabilize the mainframe, I think. I'm not too sure, but we're just going to go up 1, 2, and 1, 2, 1, 2. Grab your stone slabs, and we're just going to have them just here and going on to connect like this. So it just connects onto the side pieces like that. Of course, it's on the other same on the other side as well. So might as well just do it stupidly easy. So put up those 2, 2 like that. Put on your stone slabs like this to connect in and brace it. So there we go, that's the little front part for the first containery type thing. It's up to you if you want to have these, you know, like door type things, or if you want to have them like panels like this one, where the actual when you actually do dock, they would actually be picked up and placed to the side to get out of all of the stuff and then put back afterwards. But what we're going to do now is we're going to do the big bit here, and then the front. Okay, and now for the big middle section that we got here. What we're going to do? Well, we're going to grab our light gray wall again. It's going to be too high. And this is going to go a total of 66 blocks. So I'm actually going to use World Edit again. So I might as well, just to make it a little bit quicker for me to do this. So I do apologize for you guys that are on the console versions, but it's quite far back. 66 blocks is what you need to count. 49, 50, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, which will give 60. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, which will give 66. So, where is that in relation to things? Well, it's going to be kind of difficult, isn't it? But we've got this. Well, this will be black for you guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And if you go to that last bit, I think it's right there. Yeah, it is. So, it's nearest the back. I don't know how it's going to be easy, but I think just counting 66 blocks. And this is addition. It's not connected onto. Okay, this is the good thing about the CUI. You can see it's right there, rather than being anywhere else. But if we just do this. I'm just going to set this to 35 colon 8, 8, 8, 8, there, 8, got there in the end. Now what we're also going to do, if I just deselect this because it gets annoying after a while, is we're going to bring this line across as well. If I can actually grab it, so there we go, keep on bringing this across. It's going to be your little kind of walkway, there we go, leave that to there for the time being. Now this will just go, of course, across the back here. I don't know why I just wiped it with that. So again, I'm going to just use World Edit. I'm going to be lazy. So do it there. Is that it? Almost did it by eye, but there it is. So it's over to this point. So you have to do one across from the back. And again, just select that. And I'm going to bring this one all the way to this back point as well. So you're just building a big, big square like this. There we go. Put that in. And of course, as well, we're going to be filling up this deck with the cobblestone or grey, something like that. So if you grab that as well, put that in. So you can see how easy World Edit does. So you guys that are on the console versions, you've got 1,233 blocks to place. Unlucky. Well, you know, that's the price you pay. That's why PC is better. It is. It is. Anyway, place that down, and that's also going to be this one here. So there we go, now we have that on those. Now again, we're going to put a stripe down the middle. So let's put that stripe down from here all the way down. Just keep on flying down until you get to the end, right here. And then we're going to put in the grey stripes. There we go. Nice and easy. I just need to actually check this, I can't remember. Let's have a look at this. 3 blocks, so we've got 1, 2, 3, cool. So behind this, there's actually 3 blocks of cobblestone or grey. 1, 2, 3. Again, I'm going to make it nice and easy for myself. And World Edit it in. There we go. So I'm going to just do 4. Plop that in there. Right, now we're on to the normal stuff, or normal-ish stuff. I'm just going to put my replacer tool to the kind of iron bars that we need. We're just going to put in these connecting pieces, connecting onto the sides here, and going all the way to this side here. So we're just going to go two here, then go, and I'm just going to place down light grey wool for this. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, that'll be your iron bars. So if you're just doing it with iron bars, just do it. But, you know, you have one, two. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two. One. Oops, not there. Not that. Oh dear. Right. There. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. That's not right. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. And then two. Seven, one, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. This is the last one right here. It doesn't line up quite right, but it's good enough. Actually, I don't know why I took away those. So if you just put your iron bars in here, and I'm using the replacer tool, of course, so like this, and there, there, and here, here, across to here, and there. There we go. And then grab your stone slabs. We're just gonna put them here. It's not going on top of the actual wall, but just making it look they're kind of clipped in again, I guess. As close as it allows us enough space to walk underneath as well. Or just about anyway. And here we got one down there. So then you can just walk across this side part and go up. You can go onto the front deck. Now if you wanted to put these kind of like corrugated bits in here, you could do to have the actual gates. You could also, if you wanted to, split this into different sections, so you could have, I don't know, like the white. Well, not the white line, the grey line going across here. Not raised, but you know, cut across, or you can see where I've put in these clamps. You can use those to split it up. Or you can do it per, you know, container or whatever you want to do, or whatever you kind of find easier to actually split it up. That's it for the two kind of decks. When you do the containers, now my texture pack does actually have, if you're in the ocean biomes, will have all of the stained clay should actually be cargo containers basically. So yeah, I've already got them in the red and green and blue, light blue. So it's actually red Lyman, blue stained clay as default ones. So if you wanted those, you know, I've actually got cargo container textures. The way that I actually build them is exactly the same way that Zarius builds them for his trucks. So what I'm going to do first, I'll just slide under here. And I believe I put them 1, 2, 3. I'm just going to figure out exactly the spacing. Yep, so the way I did it on this one is I just went in by one on each of the sides, and you can see there I've just got three of them. There it leaves a block in the middle, and then you'd obviously, you know, you could mirror this or whatever. Mix it up with colours. But the actual size of them, and again, same as Zaris's trucks, so they'll fit on the back of his. It's 3 wide, and it's 13 long, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. And you'll just create this base like this. Like that. So you got a base. Then you're going to have four high. So you got one, two, three, four. So you got one, two, three, four, and then this will go across as well. Like that, and then you'll be filling up these walls. It doesn't leave that much room on the inside, obviously, but you know we have got 1 meter thick walls. So if you think of it that way, yeah. So yeah, there we go. We'll just have some like, stuff in there, and that's what your containers are going to look like, or at least the size that me and Zarius have gone for. And then we're keeping that as standard for the trains and everything, and trains, trucks, and then cargo ships like this or container ships. So just keep on stacking them and just keep on trying to randomize them. If you got my texture pack or anything like that, or if you don't have my texture pack, it doesn't really matter. Use loads of different colored wool. You could then also, you know, put in, you know, patterns and things to try and make logos. Don't know. You might have like something like this. Weird logo. You know, try out different things to make it interesting, but obviously it's only the outside bits, so when you've stacked all of them, then do your detailing type stuff. But anyway, if you want to keep on putting those up, you can, or you can do it right at the end. It's up to you. I'm actually going to get rid of that one so it's very clear to show this part. But what we're going to do now is the anchor system and a little front bit. Okay, now we're going to start working on the front part, but first, I completely forgot about these. Where we got the stairs, we need to put in the iron. Oh god, not there. God damn it. Putting the iron bars there, right? Yeah, so I completely forgot about that. Don't know how, but Yes, otherwise it wouldn't be very safe if you're walking up here. Not that it is, to be honest. You could still quite easily fall into the ocean and never be found. Well, I'm sure it'll be fine. Fine, right? Okay, so we're going to build the anchor and also the anchor system. And we've also got this big spiry thing at the front. No idea what it's for, but we got one. Maybe it's a flagpole. And then we could put a flag on it, I guess. But anyway, where we're going to go is right onto this second layer down. We've got the third one here, so we've got three. Cut out this one here, put in a block, and down, and go one, two, three, and four. I'll notice that I've got a different type of cobblestone wall, so in my texture pack, if you have Optifine, if you have World Edit, there's actually quite a few of them. 139 colon 6 is for the dark one. We've also got a light one as well, the kind of like silvery one, which is this one. So there's a couple different ones in my texture pack that you can use. I use the 139 colon 6 for this kind of anchors, but if you've just got normal, that's absolutely fine. Anyway, if you just go to the side, add two, and then add one on the top. So add two, add one on the top, and then you're going to add three on the bottom. One, two, three. So that's kind of the best we can do for a big one, anyway. Like a really massive freaking thing. Okay, and I just got completely messed up then. Anyway, after we've got this in, if we go to the back here, we're going to cut out this one and put in a light grey piece of wool and then put in an anvil. Then here, we're just going to put a raised one so it's coming out, so it's getting pulled out. I know it's not the same, but you could, I mean, use cobblestone wool, I guess. It just wouldn't work when you go to the next bits, so yeah, that's why I didn't use that. So then it's going to go up, and then going to move towards the front of the ship. I'm just going to have these two cut out, like that. Put in your anvils, and then what we're going to do is it's going to be around here. So we're going to create a cross, for the time being, like this. And in the middle of that, I'm going to put down one of the grey pieces of cobblestone wool, which in my texture pack is 139 colon 2, something like that, I think. Anyway, put a stone slab on top of it. We're then going to have an anvil this way, this way, this way, then this way. And then from here, it's going to move down into the ship. So we'd have cut out these two, maybe. And, ugh, it's going to be difficult. Go down to here. Go down again, aren't we? And then we've got to figure out a way back in. God damn it. There we go. So go back up to that point, and then you're going to put an anvil going down. And if you want to do the interior, you could have an actual chain room where these get pulled, go around that, and get pulled into the ship. So that kind of makes sense. There's also these kind of ties. Now they're not really in any specific position, so it doesn't really matter where you put them, but I'll show you how to make one. If you just put one of the dark ones down, put a netherbrick block on top or double slab, then just put them to the side like this. That's all it is. It's just so that somewhere, you know, they can get tied up with massive ropes. But if you do this on the other side, we'll get onto this pole. Okay, and then for the main kind of pole thing, I don't know what it is. Anyway, find the middle, this front part, leave two blocks, and we're going to go up by seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, like that. Around the side, just go up to this point and just add a block, then go down. Add a block, then go down. Just going to create these little stands, I guess. Now, on the back, it doesn't quite work the same way. I mean, it does, it's just not the same. And then what we're going to do is if you grab your slabs, just put these on the outside and onto these. It's going to go across like this. Obviously, the back. Can't really do anything there, but it doesn't matter. So I've just got slabs like that, and then on each of these corner pieces, we're just going to put in a slab like this, like that. So that's your stand. Now we're going to have five cobblestone wool. One, two, three, four, five. So again, I've used the silvery one. 139 colon 2, I think. I think. And then one, two, three, four, five. This is actually going to be your fence. I'm using 85 colon 1, which is a metallic fence. If not, you guys can use netherbrick fence or whatever. It's up to you. I'll just use the metallic one. But that's it for the front. Honestly, we are actually done with that front part. We're done with this whole big section. Look at this. 100 meters or so done. Now we've got this. Well, it's kind of easy. The kind of tower part is pretty easy. There's not too much detail on it except for, you know, the main stuff. You could obviously put lifeboats and things. I might show you guys example of a lifeboat, maybe. I mean, you could even have one up here, a crane up here, but just take them off my other tutorials. I've just tried to keep it simple so that these tutorials are shorter. But yeah, let's build this big tower up, and then we're done. Okay, so before we actually do that, I'm going to put on the writing on the side. We might as well get this done. So choose a name for your ship, whatever you want to call it. I mean, I went with a Greek god theme for the actual classes, so this is obviously like, well, I call this a Hermes class. But I've just got it written with Hermes on it. So I'm actually going to call this one the happy. Yeah, I'm going to call it the happy. Why not? And the place I actually did it is I went 1, 2, and then on this third one here, that's where I cut off a H. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I'm just going to do happy. I'm going to write happy. And just make it, quite big. There we go. And if you're unsure on how to do letters, just give it a go. See what works the best. So there you go. That's an A. And we have a P. So not an actual P. But I'm going to do a P like that. You could also do it, like this. It's up to you. It's really difficult to decide, I've found anyway. I might just do it. No, that looks weird. So does that look weird as well, doesn't it? And that looks even weirder. I think I'm just going to go with really blocky writing. Why not? So there we go. This is the HMS. Well, not really HMS. Depends what country it belongs to, really, doesn't it? The SS Happy. That'd be a really weird name. Oh god, how am I going to do a Y? There we go. It's easy. I got it now. That, or maybe to make it even more blocky. Yeah, so there we go. That's happy. And then all you do is just mirror this on the other side. So if you remember where you got 1, 2, 3, so this will be the where the Y is. So I just do it like here. So we just do it backwards. You can also use World Edit to actually flip it. Basically, you just you copy and paste it, rotate it by 180, and then paste it relative to where it was before. It's pretty easy, but that's what I did on my other ones. It's just that I'll do this one by hand for you guys. So all you have to do is just think in backwards. Just do the same kind of point. There we go. Put another P. And there we got an A. I don't know why I've called it the happy. That's really weird. I'm sure you guys can come up with some very cool names for these. With this one, because it's quite small, you can't really go too crazy with the name. So I'll probably keep it quite small. But where the hell did I do that? What Hey, happy, happy, happy. There we go, happy. This is purple. Just call it the purple. But that's how you do the writing. So let's get on to the back bit. Okay, so now we're just going to build up the back bit. So I'm going to do this kind of layer by layer, but it's so simple that I'm just going to do it in one take, to be honest. I'm just going to leave three of these, 1, 2, 3, and those are just going to be iron bars. So we've got those iron bars. Grab your coloured block, and what we're going to do is we're going to go from here. We're going to go a total of 26. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. And then this will go across the back like this. So it just goes over by 1. So drag this around. I'm just going to be doing this with you guys. I won't tell you to, pause or anything, because it's just stupidly easy. So if I bring this all the way up to the other side here, put in your iron bars. Of course, I'm putting in the other ones. So that's layer number 12 of that one. Layer number 13 is exactly the same, directly on top. So we're just going to build it up by one more. See? Told you it was easy. And the back is really, really straight, so it's good. So very wide ships. There we go. Continue this on. And there we go. That's that layer done. Next one, what we're going to do is it's going to be one over. So same on the top. It just goes over by one, like this, but it's still got a straight back. So it's actually just going over by one like that. And connect this on. Keep it going around. Oh, there you go, over by one. And then connect this on. Like that. Now we're just going to add an extra two to it. So just go around doing this. And I think it's a lot easier if you just walk, I think. Maybe. I don't know. I mean, I could do it with World Edit again, but I can't be bothered at the minute. So sometimes I could be bothered. And then I'll have to remember the code for purple wall that I don't actually remember. Somewhere in my head, somewhere, but like 10 or 6 or. Actually, I have no idea, so. Right, keep on doing this. And we'll go around, around. Don't know why I just jumped then. Why not? Okay, so we're almost there. It's easier to do it this way. Yeah, maybe. Do I fall off the edge? There we go. There we go. So you should have it now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 high in total, like that. Okay, and then if you grab your stone stairs, now I'm just going to go from here. I'm just going to do doubles, so we're going to keep on moving our way up. But we're going to be one short of the top because this Side bit here almost acts like a rail, like a protective rail. So we'll just go up to there, same on the other side. So we just go 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then this will go across here. We could then, you know, join that all the way across as well. And we're actually going to fill in this entire deck with that. If you first now grab your white wool, we're just going to build this up to here. Just going to straight across. And this will actually go to this level for the time being. It does go higher, but it's easier. So if you've got these gaps, then just fill them in. And fill this all in. There, and also in these bits. And build up. Keep on going. So, yep, keep on going, keep on going. And here, to here, to here. Like that. So it's on the same level as that. Now what you need to do is this entire deck needs to be filled up with your grey or cobblestone or whatever you decide to do. Well, you don't have to fill up all of it, but it's always a good idea when you're building up the towers. And also, it's a good place for a floor because it gives you down here, gives you 3 blocks. And this one, I think there's only 3 blocks per kind of bit or floor on this one, which is quite nice. So you've always got a little bit more room. So fill that up and we'll get on to the next bit. Okay, so now if we go to the front part where we've got this, so we've got this white bit kind of on the front, we're just going to add an extra 8 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Because I'm lazy, I've gone back to being lazy again. I'm just going to make this white wall because it's 171 blocks and that will save me a lot of time. So we go as long as you're 8 high, it should be fine. That's just like the most, the kind of widest bit of this section, just means we can just pull blocks from it. But what we're going to be doing is going backwards by 22, counting that once. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, and 22. And this will be 3 blocks high. So, again, I'm going to be lazy. I'm going to world edit. And I'm going to, yeah, clear my selection. That's great. Yep. And here we go. And I'm going to world edit. So, sometimes being quicker isn't always the best thing. There we go. World edit there. I'm also going to do the same on the other side. So we go 1, count that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, and 22. So again, just going to shove that on there and again do this. And then this time I am going to deselect there. So if we go back to around the back, we're going to have 5 going this way. So if you've already got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, build that up. And then we're going to add an extra 1 on the back here. And then we're going to go across by 3. 1, 2, 3. And build that up. And then we're going to go back again and have another 3. It's kind of a bit weird, this one. It really is. So it's building like this. So on the other side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Add an extra block here. And we'll build this bit up. So I think it's ridiculously bright as well. That's what shaders do to it. Then we're going to have 3 blocks here. So I'll give you guys a shot of it from the top. There you go. So that's what it looks like. That's what you should have. With these bits being 5, there's 2 here, 3, 3, 3, and then goes around like that. So yeah, what we're going to do next is we'll just build up the outside part of this, and this gets brought all the way to the edge, and then we have a beam going down. And we're also going to bring this all the way across to the side and attach this, and I think that goes there. I can't remember where the extra one goes here, but we'll put it in a bit. So yeah, this is just going to be where this is here. Let's build this up. And here, build that up. And oops, that doesn't go there. It goes over to the edge, puts on a beam, like a support beam, I mean. And then this gets dragged over. Put in those, put in another one. And you can guess what we're going to be doing next. We're going to be filling up another floor. So this layer up here is another floor, as you can see. So guess what you're going to be doing? You're going to be filling in this. You're going to be pausing the video, filling in another floor. But don't worry, there's not too many of them. There's 1, 2. Three, four floors. Don't worry, they get a lot smaller. This is the deck that we're building now, so then next bit gets a lot smaller. So fill in all of that. It'll give you another floor for interior type stuff. And we'll get on to the next kind of level. Okay, and now for the next little bit. We're gonna have to do this in two separate bits because it does get a bit weird. And it kind of makes more sense to build another bit before we build the other bit. You'll see what I mean. Anyway, what we're gonna do is we're just gonna go straight across with these parts. So there we go, connect that up. Then this will go a total of 9. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Again, I'm going to be really lazy, but there you go, you can see it's 9. There. So, oh god. Where's my. There. That's what I wanted. So there we go, I've been lazy. Now this one goes across by 5. So you've already got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And build this up. Like that. And then over here, this is just going to go 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Like that. And then right on this end, we're just going to put 2 right here. Like that. Now on this section, we're actually going to cut out this one and put down some stairs. There's actually some stairs going in. It's pretty cool. And oh, there. Let's put it upside down as well. And we can actually fill in at least a little bit of this deck. We'll wait until we get all of the section first. It's just an overhang, isn't it? It's just over. I can overwatch you a bit. Yeah, we've got that bit there. So if we just do the same on the other side, so we got from here. Build this up. There. And this just goes 9. So we're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So that's 9 in total shown. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And grab that. Put in your thing. And then what we're going to do is go across by 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's 5 in total. And build it up. And here we're going to have 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Build that up. And then add an extra 2 there. Cut out this one. Put in a stair. And work our way down. Put in your upside down stairs as well. If we can, god damn, put those in. There we go. And then you get your stairs going up as well. So you could actually fill this. I'm pretty sure if we just fill across to here, or right to here maybe. Yeah, do it right to there maybe. Right to that point. Fill everything else front with your actual deck colour. And then we'll get around to this back bit, or we might build the next part up first and then attach onto this smokestack and pieces. Okay, so what we're going to do next is if we just find the middle, there we go, and you can find it quite easily by finding the middle line, following that up all the way to here, like that. We're then going to add 7 to each side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That should give you 15 in total. So here we go, let's just double check. There you go, that'll give you 15. Then what we're going to do is we're going to go across by 10. So you've already got your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Good God. I've already lost it. I've already lost it. I need to count 9. There you go, 9, 10. And if I just do these like that. And then that'll just go across the back as well. So the same bit. So this will create the next box. Just makes it a little bit easier for us to work off. So just create this to, it's 4 high for the time being on this one. We can always cut it out later on, so make it 4 high. There, and same on the back. Up to here, keep on grabbing it across. And just creep on making this big box. And yes, I didn't use world edit on this bit, which just cost me a lot of time. And there, see there. Right, to here, to here, to here. Build all of these up like that. That'll give us the little back section there. Okay, and then if you come to the back of this part, what we're going to do, so we've got this kind of bit that we've been moving upwards. It's going to add an extra 2. So there we go, we've got an extra 2 going up. You guys can see that properly. There we go. Extra 2 going up. And then we're just going to have a 1, just for the time being. It does actually overhang, but we'll do that in a second. Now where the floor is here, I'm actually going to bring this to this point, so we're going to bring it forwards. You can actually fill in all of this bit as well, across there. Fill in this one, like that. So then we've got this little balcony type area. We're actually going to have right here the stairs. So these stairs actually go down like that. And there's a little bit behind, I need to have a look at that. It's really fiddly, I think, over at this point. So have a look at that and stuff in a second, but if we just put in these stairs for now. We're putting these stairs down here, and there, there, and there, and I'm just going to have a look over at the other side. Okay, and then for the next bit behind here, what we're going to do, we're going to place a block directly next to this one, then we're going to go an extra one, and if we bring this down to the floor, it's going to be 6 in total. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Build that wall up to 4, like this. And just behind this, we're actually going to build a wall here, like a double wall. And this is actually where I put in a door, so you can do the same. Also put in your upside down stairs. Like this. Just makes a nice little gap. Then on this part we're going to have white I'm gonna have five sets or five blocks of light gray wool. Two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. And just build all of this up like that. Do the same on the other side. So we've got one block here, build it all the way down. Build a back wall, or you can put in a door if you want to. I think what I'll do is I'll show you where the doors are, windows, when we've got everything done. This will go six, so you got one, two, three, four, five, six. Just gonna have one there. Build this up. Oh, there we go. I'm not falling down too much. Like that. And then just on the sides, we're just going to put in the cobblestone, just on these sides. Doesn't go all the way around, but it does go down to those bits. I don't know really why, but you can at least stand here. And then you have to walk back. But anyway, you get those little bits in there. I think we put in the upside down stairs here. Nope, we didn't. So we're going to put in those as well. And there we go. Put in the upside down stairs, just like that. You also notice we haven't put in the iron bars yet. We'll just do it in a big kind of end piece. It's just gonna be easier. I think what we're gonna do now is we'll just build up the bridge and then we'll actually build up the smokestack as a separate entity. I think it's gonna be easier. But you can kind of see where it slots in now. Okay, and now for the next bit. We're gonna actually build the extensions that are on the side of these that kind of stick out a bit. So if you grab your white wool and we're gonna go and count up these. Well, you're gonna be basically the second one down from where we've always placed, and we're gonna be one block back. We're gonna go four, one, two, three, four. And then it goes back by one here, and then we're going to have a 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This then will connect across the side. So there you go, you can kind of see it there. It's actually all going to be solid as well. I believe it's solid. I think it's solid anyway. No, maybe not. I think it actually might be light grey. Oh, no, that is solid. Sorry, guys. After I make my mind up, it'll be solid. Right, so if we do the same on the other side anyway. So we're going to go here. One, two, three, and four. And then we're gonna have a one. Now we're gonna have a seven. So we've got a seven here. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Attach that one across, make this all solid. If it isn't solid, we'll fix it in a second anyway. I'm sure I'll find out. So the next bit, we're gonna be up another layer. We're gonna go three blocks. One, two, and three. Then on top of here, we're gonna go three. One, two, three. So it's just staggered back slightly. It's moving back just a little bit. I'm gonna attach one onto the back here. Then this is also going to be three blocks, so we're actually going to have this 2x3. That would have been easier. I've just written it down really weird. Yeah, we've got a 2x3 there. And then what we're going to do is we're going to have one here, which goes all the way around. And this actually, I think, wraps all the way around the back. So this will wrap all the way around the back to here. And I'll join across. So if we do the same on the other side, we've got three blocks here. One, two, three. Three blocks here. One, two, three. Which is actually, yes, double this up. That's so much easier. Why didn't I write that down? And then what we're going to do is we're going to have seven here. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Well, actually, eight because it goes over. And you notice that we get this, like, this place to place down stuff. So we're going to fill this with cobblestone, grey, whatever it is. We're just covering up basically the floor from underneath because it's quite high up. Like that. You could also use for the bit underneath this quartz slabs, but I just use four blocks because, like, you know, why not? But yeah, if you guys want to also fill up this point from here to here, like I'm going to do in about 2 seconds, it's only 104 blocks, so shouldn't take you too long. But if you do that, we'll now get on to the next bit. Okay, and now for the next bit, what we're going to do is if you grab your wool, we're going to go one, two, three, and just three blocks, not four, because we've got a color on the top, you see. So then this comes forwards, and we'll just be like this. And then one, so it's directly on top of this kind of line that we've got here. As you can see, it's actually there. Now this one goes back by nine, so you've already got one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and then this we can actually change out for grey. See, it's already been covered up like that. So then this will go straight across the back. This is actually the bridge section, so yeah, pretty cool. Build this all the way up, and I'm going to do it by hand, which will probably take longer than, well, it will take longer than the world edit one. But oh well, who cares, right? Alright, so then we get this, like that, and like that, like that. And on the front, you'll notice I've left it blank. That's because we've got two layers of glass. So there we go. Shove in all the glass, like that. Now, I have got a cool kind of glass in mind, so I'm going to use, again, you'll need world edit or Optifine type stuff. So 20.3 is actually this kind of glass with things on it. Kind of cross, so it's kind of cool, and I think it looks a little bit better, maybe. It's very simple, but yeah. And then what we're going to do is we're going to extend, well, not extend the extension, we're going to continue the extension. And where we're going to go is from here, we're going to go 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Then we're going to add an extra one on the back, like that, so it makes it 2. Then we're going to have 3 blocks, 1, 2, 3, and then a 1. That's all we're going to do. Just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Add one to this part, and then we're going to have 3, 1, 2, 3, and then a 1. Now, if you grab your, coloured wool, I've used purple. You can use a different colour for this top piece if you wanted to. I'm just going to use the same one, to be honest, but we're going to go across this part and onto the top of this, and then we're actually going to follow this line. So we're going to do exactly the same as what we've got down here, like that. And then I think this one just goes right in and then goes around. I might have to double check it. I'm pretty sure that's what it does. So yes. So if we do that, go across to here, there, and there, and there. Join across to that. Yeah, all we need to do then is just whenever we got one of these extra pieces, just add an extra connecting bit in. These, like this, and here, and here. And then grab your cobblestone. Gonna be filling up that floor, as you probably know. So yeah, fill up all of this. It's gonna be your roof for it. Just gonna have to put a sensory type thing on it. And we'll do that after we've got the smokestack done, because that's the next kind of big piece, I guess. There we go, get all those. Fill up this, fill up this. There we go, almost done. And again, I should have done this with World Edit. God damn it. I'm sure somebody there's just done it with World Edit in about 2 seconds. So there we go, we get that piece like that. Now I need to actually have a quick look. I've just forgotten what I was going to do. I did write it down. Well, not write it down, in my head. Just got one here, one there, one there. So we're going to put in these little beams. Grab some cobblestone wall anyway. And we're going to go here. Leave a block. Go there, leave a block, go there. Now on the back, you just do it on this piece here and this piece here. Well, you could, I guess, do it on there, but I don't know. I can't even remember what I did. I can't even see what I did. Too bright. Yeah, okay, so I went in the middle and then went there. Alright, so I've done it completely different on the back. It doesn't really matter. But yeah, if we do it right in the middle of this one, right on the edge of that one. And this time I've used the white version, which is 139 colon 3. I think. I'm not 100% sure, even of my own textures, so yeah, we've got those. But there is a white variant if you want it, or you can use the silverish one. There you go, that just gives you the extension, that gives you the big bridge section. Look at that. Mega. Mega duper massive. Mega. Even more mega. What we're also going to do is put in the stairs. So, if we go down onto this section, we're going to leave one, two, three, and then this is where we're going to have them cut up, I believe. So you're gonna have to cut quite a bit up, but there and there. There we go. So that gives us some stairs. You can also, if you wanted to, I think I did on mine, put in here and I put in either just a block or a blocker. Or you can also put in like iron bars or fence or something. It just means that you don't. Obviously, people would actually probably fall down the stairs because people are dumb. So that's what they would do in real life. Just put your upside down stairs on those bits as well. So if we go to the other side, down here, and one, two, three, go to the fourth, right our way up, cut as much as we need to. There, and there. And I'm just going to go a block for this one. Makes more sense, doesn't it? There you go. So then you kind of get around here. Obviously, you can still fall off the side and break your ankle or whatever, but there's no helping some people. Yeah, that's pretty much it for the main bit, the main kind of chunks, I guess, without all the smokestack and stuff. What we could do now, actually, is whenever we got one of these, just connect around it. And you know what that means if you've done one of my tutorials before. It means we're going to be doing a lot of fence, not fencing, but iron barring. Now, on this one, just follow the white line. So when it comes to here, just hit it into the side of this, because that's where the smokestack is. But go around these lines. Just not on the purple one. Actually, I'll show you one here. That's easier. So on this balcony here, on this back bit here, on the side bits here that goes across, on this bit connecting all the way across here, and you can see here I did the iron bar. I actually prefer the block now, and these just wrap in. So put those in. We'll put on the smokestack. Put on this thing. Put in the windows and doors, and I'll go through a couple ideas for things like life. boats or whatever, and we can put a couple of them on there. Might make it look better. It probably would make it look better. So let's do that. Okay, now for the actual smokestack. So you can actually tell that it looks really weird without it. I didn't realize. It looks so slopey forwards. Anyway, what we're going to be doing here is going to be adding four blocks with your light gray. One, two, three, four. And build that all the way up. So to here. Like this. Put three of them in the middle. Like that. Then we're going to move back to this point. And go one, two, three, four. And just move around it. There. So that's going to be solid as well. And in the middle of this, we're going to have two sets of three. So we've got one, two, three, like that. Now, I'm going to have to do this bit in sections because it's a little bit weird, but counting this one here, it goes. Actually, if we just continue this on here, let's go to this point. And then this goes a total of eight high. So you've got one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So we're right to this point, and we're just going to join these walls as well. There we go. Like this. And then across the back, of course, that'll get joined straight. So this is going to be the same. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Join those across. Like this. Like that there. And of course, across the back as well. Oh, if I can find this bit. So join this all to the same height. And now I'm just going to find out what to do here. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to have three blocks on the side. One, two, three, just on this part. One, two, three. Which then means this goes back right to here. And if we just join this across as well. Just straight to that point, like that. Then I have one, one, and this goes up by two. This goes up pretty much solid, actually. Pretty easy to explain. So there, and then one there. So you got these two bits here down, and then the rest are up. So then down here, we're going to put in black wool. It's going to be one block down, and then put in your nether brick fence, which gives you the actual smokestack idea. Well, not idea. Smokestack thing. They can put, obviously, cobwebs going back in a big cloud, or you can use, I've seen like wool and also stained glass. I've seen that been used before, which looks pretty cool. People using white stained glass and then actually having this go up to make it look like clouds and stuff and doing really cool stuff, but more broken and you know what I mean. It looks better without shaders with that one. So now we're just going to finish off the roof. So first, what I want you guys to do is, if you haven't already, I've just completely forgot, but is just, go around the edge of this part with your iron bars again. So go around all of this with your iron bars. We'll finish off that, have a couple ideas for the boats, and that'll be it. Okay, now for the sensory type bit, what we're going to do, if you find the middle, leave a two block gap and go up by five with your light grey wool. One, two, three, four, five. On the front, we're going to go up by three. One, two, three. We're going to have a one, just like this. Around the top, we're going to have three cobblestone wool. Three cobblestone wool. Yeah, one, two, three. So I'm using the metallic one again. And then three fence. So I'm going to use my metallic one, using my replacer tool. So that's 85 cone one again, just in case you don't remember. But normal fence, normal nether brick fence will work completely and utterly fine. So now what we're going to do is right on here, we're going to add three slabs. One, two, three. Same on the other bit. One, two, three. And then on this one, we're going to add two. One, two. And one, two. So, that, for all intents and purposes, is the end of the tutorial, at least what I've taught for this. Well, actually, it's not. We need doors. Good God. Yeah, we need the doors and windows and stuff. But first, I'm just going to give you a couple of ideas for boats, because otherwise I will forget. So, let's grab some orange wool, something like that. Life rafty type stuff. And this is just going to be really, really simple. Around this back piece, we could have, for example, a boat. And so I'm going to go with three blocks between these two. Go with these, go with that. And then all you need to do is just build some nice orange thing like this, and that could just be a boat. You got yourself a life raft done. And you might be wondering, what should I do for the floor? Well, you could do anything. You could put slabs or whatever. Oh, about dropping them down, pick them up. There we go. So you can have slabs in here like this, and then do those. You can do stuff like that. Really simple. You could put a couple of those down. You could then put a crane in, for example. So you could do something like this. Actually, it's even. That's weird. It's not like me to do even. But you could have one like here, go one, two, three, and actually have it go just very simply like this. And maybe even just add a couple of slabs onto it or something, I don't know. Slabs onto these bits and down here. These are very simple. And then have your nether brick fence go all the way up. There you go, to that point, and then just go down. And have something really, really simple, You don't have to be crazy. I don't really like that one. I've got better ones on my other ship tutorials, so if you guys have done those, you probably know which ones are better. I can't actually remember. But anyway, that's that for that. We're going to put on the windows. Pretty easy, pretty standard. And that will be it for the tutorial. Okay, so let's get these windows done. I'm not going to do them exactly the same as that one, but I'm going to show you the kind of pattern that I actually use for them. So if we just go, for example, on the front part, we might as well do this, as I've put loads of windows on this one. You can always cut down on them. But what I generally do is a wall kind of rule. We go one, two, and then we go to the third one. We never do it here, even though that looks better on the outside. We actually go on the inside, and this will actually be a good place. If we go one, two, and then cut out a door here, for example, and you can see that my wooden pressure plates are invisible. Not in the actual texture pack, but, well, in the texture pack with Conquest. Kind of Conquest. I'm going mad today. I think it's been too long, too many tutorials, with connected textures and stuff. But you can see the window actually fits there, whereas otherwise it would fit there. And it always looks weird when it's there. So it's to kind of look better on the outside as well. But yeah, I actually need to put these upside down. Don't do that. Right, so there we go. So yeah, that's why I put those there. So now I just go every other one, and that'll figure itself out. Then if we go down the next one, we're going to leave a 3 block gap. One, two, three. One, two, three, four. And we'll see if we can get another one in. Which we can. Can we get another one in? Yep, we can get another one, but we can't get one to there. So I'll leave it right there. Doesn't really matter. The other thing we can do, of course, is then offset these ones to have maybe like this one here. Actually, that looks pretty good. That looks a bit better. So I'm going to do that there. So there we go. That's actually offset that from this moon block. That actually looks better than I've got. So yeah, there you go. And then leave another three blocks. One, two, three. And then we're going to do more, just on the same bits. And then you can see here, this actually has the two. So there we go. It's actually fit in correctly. There we go again. And just move down to the last one. One, two, three. We'll get down to here. Oh, not there. There. Every other one, and then you can see down into the bowels of the ship where I haven't done any doors. You could also put doors here, I guess. Put one on the side. Let's just go here and here, because I use the wood, the actual iron doors. I always put them on like that. So I'm putting doors here, and same on the other side. Put them in like this. Putting those there. Right, there we go. We got those doors. We got those windows for the front face. Pretty cool. Now what I'd do for the actual bridge section, we might as well work from the top down, I guess. Because we've got a block gap here, we could just put in a door. To be honest, that's a good place for the door. Switch out that floor block. And there we go. Now on the other side as well, cut out this, and get that floor block away. Put this in, put that in there. Then every other one, we're going to go and put in a window. So, that doesn't quite work out. I think here I actually went in with a double window in the end, because it doesn't work out. And then on the back, we're just going to go every other one using that same rule that I did. So you've got the two on the sides, so whenever you get a corner piece. And we have two there, and then one. There we go. So that means that we get quite a bright, bridge section. We've got lots of places to look out. You can also walk around here. You can look out over the sides. It's pretty good view-wise anyway, I think, overall. So if we go down to the next bit, let's go over to here. We've already got a door in, so that's good. If we go here, we'll go every other one. Currently fit one there, so we go and skip that one. So that would be one there. And that seems to work, or does it? I'm not sure. Yeah, I would actually leave that. So you can leave that one, or you can have it there. We'll have one here instead, actually. Let's do one there. So you gotta work it from the inside as well, and you can actually kind of figure it out. Usually from the other side. There. And a window here. I think I went with one there in the end, didn't I? Is that right? Yes, that's right. There we go. If we jump around to the back, so I put a door here. Again, oh, god damn it. Same reasoning, anyway. There. So same reasoning with the doors as well. Just put them in the same place. Then we're just going to alternate with windows, even though there's no real point for these back ones. So I'll probably take them out. But we'll do that in a second. Put down these doors. So I think probably have that one kept, and then take out this one and take out this one. Because there's no point having a window to a big bloody smokestack. Think about the cost that it would take to put in a window. Won't make sense. Don't put any windows on the smokestack, because that would also be pretty dumb. But what we're going to do now is we'll move down to this bit, this little extension that we got on the side. And also, I completely forgot about these extension pieces here. So when you've got the box there, put them on the side like that. I'm going to leave a two-block gap and have just these. Should work its way out. There you go, you've got two there. And again, here you probably want a door. Yeah, put a door in here. This is back section from there. And then what we're going to do here, probably nothing there. But on this bottom piece we will. Right in here we're going to put in a door. So I'll have a door in here as well. And probably add an extra bit there, I guess. So is that the same? No, not there. There. Alright, so then putting this here. You can find the door. There we go. Got a door for that one. So we've got a door there, door there. Door there. We're also going to have the door here again. So same on the other side. And also put in these little bits. Not there. I need to grab that now. So you can see how the kind of method works, and then you can just apply it to other ships. Don't be exact with it though. And then if we leave two here and put in one, two here and put in one, there we go, so it's more windows. You can even have a window there, but I don't think it'd make much sense, so I'm not going to do that. So two, put in one there. That gives us quite a nice little bright back bit. Obviously the smokestack would then go all the way down through the ship, but interior-wise, you can ignore it unless you want it to be accurate. Okay, so that's most of it. It's just down here on this bottom bit, isn't it, really? So, if we just continue around here, we've got the windows. Going to leave two, put in one, leave two. This will be a door. Makes sense to have a door right at the top of the stairs, so you can just, you know, come out and then walk down. So I could just run across. Put in one there. That's where the window will go. So, there. Shove in the door. Might as well continue from this side now. So yeah, every other one. Throw in a window. And except for the end one. Maybe you could do a double one there. I don't know, why not? Let's do a double one there. Then here, it's going to have one window in the middle. There we go. And this one we're going to have a window there. Then we're going to have a window there. A window there. So right in the middle there. Two, and then we have a double here. And then it's every other one. There we go. So that's it. Pretty cool. What I'll probably do at the back is have this one here as a door. Oh god, weird. Didn't mean to do that, but have like one of those as a door, or have that one as a door. I can't remember what I did in this one. I had that one as a door. So this one actually had a door there and a door there, but might as well just have one in the middle. But that's pretty much it for the tutorial, guys. There's no more details, I don't think. That's pretty much it. I think the only thing we can add, and this is just like an optional extra as well, as we've got the writing on the side, what I did for mine is also put a big, basically the initials on the back. So we've got this here, you can see here I've got HE because it was Hermes, so HE, Hermes, kind of makes sense. I mean, that could also be Hercules, but for Hercules, HC I think I'm going to go for, something like that, I don't know. But let's do HA for happy. So if you find the center line, just go over to the one block, and we're just going to do it again, five. So one, two, three, four, five, and down to here. There, and HA. So there we go. So I can put that in, and I did this in light grey wool instead of white. It's up to you what you want to do it in. But I just did it in light grey because it was a little bit different. But that's it for the ship, guys. Hopefully you've enjoyed it. If you have, make sure you comment, like, and subscribe. And I will see you guys on the next one.